2, 3.
Woohoo!
It's time for positive actions!
Hola! Es hora de acción positiva!
Mrs. Hot and
Miss Shema!
We welcome you to the Morgan County Partnership's Positive Action Daily Community Vlogcast.
La señora Hot y Shema os damos la bienvenida a los vídeos diarios de Acción Positiva.
Today is Fun Friday!
Hoy es Viernes Vistazón!
Let's get ready for a awesome day of learning and wellness.
¿Listos para un día alucinante de aprendizaje y bienestar?
The positive action word for this week is curiosity, and in Spanish, curiosidad.
Now watch this beautiful video of Fun Friday!
Hi everybody, my name is LJ, and today the word is curiosity, and the word Spanish is
curiosidad.
To all the women, to all the girls whose stories are in this book, thank you for being leaders. Thank you for being brave. Thank you for being bold. We are grateful and inspired. And, are you ready? To all the leaders yet to come, big or little, I cannot wait to hear your stories. Hi, it's Mrs. Hot from the Morgan County Partnership, and I'm here with you today to celebrate Black History Month. And for this time, we're going to continue with our Tuesday series on race and diversity with a book called Little Leaders, Bold Women in Black History. I'm really excited to introduce you to girls from our past who struggled, who were different, they were unique, and they were wonderfully made. And they were able to find their strength and do some really cool things. Are you ready? Let's get started. Little Leaders, Bold Women in Black History, written by Vashti Harrison. Let's listen to what she says about this book. This book grew out of a project I began during Black History Month. It started as a drawing challenge to myself to illustrate one African American from history every day for the month of February and post the finished image to social media with a brief summary of the woman's accomplishments. As I researched and read amazing stories of women, both known and unknown, I was surprised to be moved so deeply. As a Black woman, I have studied the history of my people, but never have I felt this connected to the beauty and the passion behind their boldness. Whether they were fighting for their families or for social justice, or daring to become an artist or an astronaut, each one of these women broke barriers for those who came after her. That's you and that's me, right? And they use their differences to be bold and to be leaders. We can do that too. Let's listen. In a society where being Black and female meant being an outsider or sometimes even invisible, these women who dared to go after what they wanted, to demand what they deserved. Some of them were reluctant leaders, while others were not even conscious of their bravery, but their legacies live on to prove the way for more of us to follow. Many of them didn't set out to be pioneers, but all of them were, and we can look to each one of them for inspiration. And that's why Mrs. Hot wants to share their stories for you, okay? We want to look to them for inspiration on how we can too overcome our struggles and look for others who have the same hardships we do and be able to overcome them, who look like us or who are different than us, and realize as we come together, we can be positive. Let's keep looking. I wanted to tell you, this is from Vashti Harrison, she wanted to tell you all their stories together to celebrate not only their collective contribution to history, but also their diversity. Some of them you will recognize, such as Harriet Tubman and Rosa Parks, but you'll also meet less famous figures, such as Alice Ball and Mary Bowser. You'll meet scientists, politicians, doctors, painters, sculptors, dancers, and they are all black women. This in no way means that this book is only for black girls or boys. I hope readers of every background find these stories compelling and inspiring, but I did create it with them, my younger self, in mind. I think about what kinds of dreams I might have if I had known all about these women when I was growing up. If I'd known that so many people who looked like me and had done such incredible things were able to. To be able to see yourself in someone else's story can be life-changing. Let me read that again. To able to see yourself in someone else's story can be life-changing. To know that a goal is achievable can be empowering. I hope that anyone who reads these biographies, whether or not they look like these little leaders, is inspired to go after the things that they are passionate about. Oh, it gives me goosebumps. This collection includes only a handful of the countless bold black women who have done extraordinary things and lived incredible lives. With these mini biographies, I hope to spark your interest and encourage you to find out more about them and the women who have followed in their footsteps. It could be you. The Little Leaders are here to guide you on this journey through history. I originally envisioned them as little girls serving as stand-ins for these famous women. That's why they're little. But as I've started sending them out into the world, they've become bigger than I could imagine. I designed them to be interchangeable because I want you, the reader, to see yourself in any one of them and to feel their strength and their possibility in you. With every turn of the page, you'll discover a new bold woman who changed history. Let them inspire your future too. Are you ready? Are you ready, Positive Actions? Let's take a look at some of these. Mrs. Holt wants to share them with you and celebrate these women. And maybe, just maybe, one of you out there will find something similar to what they're going through, or to how they look, or what they're living, and you'll find your path too. Are you ready? Our next little leader is Mary Bowser, a Civil War spy. Oh, another spy. Very little is recorded about Mary's life. What we do know is that she was born into slavery in Richmond, Virginia, around 1840. She was purchased by the wealthy Van Loo family as a companion for their daughter, Elizabeth. The Van Loos were no ordinary family in the South, though. They had a secret. They were Northern spies and abolitionists involved in the secret Underground Railroad. We just heard about someone else there, right? Prior to the war, when Mary was a teen, Elizabeth granted her freedom and arranged for her to receive her education in Philadelphia. Mary wanted to assist the Van Loos in their efforts against the Confederacy. At that time in the South, it was illegal for a black person to have an education or to even read. Wow. For that reason, no one would ever suspect Mary was a threat. As a slave, she could hide in plain sight. So she agreed to go undercover as a slave in Jefferson Davis's Confederate White House. While cleaning, she would steal glances at confidential memos, and while serving dinner, she would eavesdrop on conversations between Confederate officials. She passed information about troop movements and army plans to Elizabeth, who passed them along to Union officials. Rumor has it that Mary had a photographic memory and was able to read a page and recite it back word for word. Wow, what a gift. After the war, Mary educated freed slaves and traveled around the United States giving speeches. For a long time, she was careful to conceal her true identity using a variety of aliases. Eventually, she disappeared completely, but she is remembered. In 1995, she was inducted into the Military Intelligence Hall of Fame.
Wow.
Congratulations to Mary Bowser, a little leader. We take you to meet a friend out in our community. How about that, Ms. Shayma?
That's really exciting.
That's really exciting. Now, we're going to meet a special friend today, and we're going to hear what inspires them, what their favorite books are, and what positive actions they do every day out in the community. You know why?
Why?
Because we want you to do positive actions too.
Stay tuned, meet a new friend that cares about you.
You.
Have a great day.
Bye. Positive actions. And if you have a moment, can we interview you for the Daily Positive Actions vlogcast?
Sure.
Oh, that's awesome. Thanks for letting me interrupt you, okay?
That's okay.
All right, Morgan County students, it is Fabulous Fun Friday.
What's Fabulous Fun Friday?
Oh my goodness, let me tell you, that's a great question. Glad you asked. On Fridays, we show our students in Morgan County, people in the community that care about each of you guys. And today we found a really special person in Berkeley Springs, and she is the managing editor of the Morgan Messenger. Can you please tell everyone what your name is?
My name is Sandy Buzzard.
Sandy Buzzard. Now, you know what, boys and girls? I recognize that name because I have a good friend. Her name was Betsy Buzzard, and I know the Morgan Messenger was started as a family business. Can
you
tell
Betsy?
Us? I do know Betsy.
Oh, good.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, we used to climb through this window right there from their house, and we'd run around in here, and then we'd go out, and they'd say, close the window. So we used to play in here, but we were this big.
Yeah, I met Betsy when she was about 10.
Is that right?
That's right. Long ago.
It's been a while, huh?
It's been a while, yes.
Yeah, and so how long have you been at the Morgan Messenger?
I've actually been here since 1984.
1984? That's yes. Just after that's when Betsy graduated from high school.
Oh, is it?
Yes,
yes
it is.
I guess it was.
1984. Yes. And yes. Tell us, at the Morgan Messenger, what do you do?
Well, as a managing editor, you do a lot of things. You don't necessarily write. But you make all the components come together. For instance, there's ad people, mm-hmm. there's writers, And it all has to come together, so at the end of the week or on Wednesday, there's a newspaper. So I make sure everybody here is working and happy at working, and then it all comes together.
You know what? That's a positive action. Coordinating and helping people in their daily jobs. And it's important to feel positive, and it happens every week because you have a deadline, right?
Right, right.
Right.
And that's when it comes really hard because we have to have a deadline because we have a time to print.
Oh,
and if
right.
we don't print, there's no newspaper.
I know, and I'm looking for the paper every Wednesday, Miss Sandy.
Oh, good.
And I'm looking for it. And you know what's kind of similar? Students, you guys in the classroom, your teacher gives you things to do too, and she says it's due tomorrow, right? So you have to figure out how to make it all come together as well. And that's important. You might be thinking, oh, why do I have to do this? Or I don't want to have that test on Friday in spelling or whatever. But it's good practice because after school, it still happens. There are deadlines and commitments and things to do, and it's a positive action to work hard, right?
Yeah, because you know, when you get older, you have a job.
Uh-huh.
And somebody wants you to be there at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock, you need to be there.
Right, absolutely. So let's ask you a few questions for our students.
Okay, are they gonna be hard ones?
Maybe.
Oh, okay.
Maybe. No, they're not hard, I'm just teasing, but I forgot the first question.
When you were a little girl, what did you want to be when you grew up?
Actually, I wanted to be an accountant.
Really?
I liked playing
money?
I love money, but I liked playing with numbers.
Numbers!
Yeah,
wow.
You know, for some reason, I would see numbers a little bit different, and
That's cool. Easier
for me to add and multiply, believe it or not. Yeah.
Look at that, girls. Numbers, math, it's important, right?
Mm-hmm.
And seeing things and managing things. That, you know, the same things your brain is doing with numbers and math multiplication, you do as a managing editor too. You know, it takes good brain power.
Well, and believe it or not, at the end of the day, you have to make sure you make money to be able to print a newspaper.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't think of that.
Yeah. Yeah. See, there's
Oh, the business side of it.
Yeah.
So you guys have been making the paper since, what was that year?
1893.
How many years is that? It's 2019. I can't do that. Well, that's a lot of years to have a paper that's profitable that it keeps on going.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Wow, that's cool. So let's ask you another question. I'm curious. What is your favorite book?
Believe it or not, I like autobiographies.
Oh, yeah?
I like learning about people, but some of you might find that a little bit boring. But
yeah.
When...
Well, you write about people too, so that makes sense as a newspaper person.
Yeah. There was an interesting book about Sammy Davis Jr.
Oh!
And I just found his life so fascinating.
Really?
That I think that might have been the first autobiography I ever read, and then I searched them out. But probably as far as the fun side is concerned, Gone with the Wind is a classic.
Uh-huh,
I mean,
yes.
It's a classic, and you know, you can go back and reread it, you know, because of all the history.
It's a beautiful
story, yes. Yeah.
And when you read Gone with the Wind, you see so much in your mind.
It's
so descriptive. That's neat.
And that's the fun part about reading, is because when you're reading, the images that are in your head are your images.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
not what you read,
uh-huh.
It's what I read.
Uh-huh.
And what I'm seeing may be totally different than what
from
you're
what
seeing.
I see, or right. When Shamer reads it. Like,
yeah.
So we all three can read Gone with the Wind, and
but
all three have
different.
A
yeah.
different experience.
Yes.
See, guys, reading is super cool. Look at that. And girls, read a lot. That's important. Do that. That's cool. Oh, I have another question.
Okay.
Did you do a positive action today?
Well, I believe I did. I had to take my dog to Leona's this morning,
aww.
Where he's getting groomed. But I decided, since I was going that way, she actually is putting in a Christmas ad.
Oh!
It's a beautiful card. So what I did is I blew it up on the copier and took it to her as a gift.
Aww.
So that, you know, she could see what her ad was going to be like in a big form.
That's so thoughtful. Oh, that's awesome. And you know what's cool too? You have a dog.
Yes,
see?
Yes I do. I have a golden retriever, Major. And he's very lovable, and he's a good dog.
That's neat.
And he's going to smell really good when he comes back.
Yeah, he's going to get him today. Be all nice and beautiful. That's cool. Okay, one last question for you, and then we'd like to take a look. She's got some great awards in here. But before we take a look, one last question. This is my favorite question. What inspires you every day to run a newspaper?
Oh, to run a newspaper. I thought maybe you were going to do the personal end.
We can do both. Tell us, yeah.
As far as the paper is concerned, it's been in my husband's family since 1893. And it's an important part of the community.
Oh, I love it.
If I didn't work with the newspaper, I don't know what I would do. You know, I like making people happy, and I hope that some of the stories in the paper will make people happy. At least it gets them the information.
Mm-hmm. That's so valuable. So, and we, our community, what you do at the paper, sharing the stories from the schools, I think that's beautiful them to see, because it validates the efforts and it gives people a sense of purpose. You know what I mean?
Personally, I have a daughter that has medical issues. And she's been that way since she was about 12 years old. But you know what? She gets up every day with all of her problems and medical issues, and she puts her best foot forward. She tries to put a smile on every day. And if she can do it, I can make every day worth living. You know, if she can do it, I can do it too. Yes.
There you go, guys. Oh, yeah, that's my heart, too. That warms my heart. Oh, Miss Sandy, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
That was beautiful. Beautiful stories. Now, before we head over there, I know you guys have got to get to class, and you've got a busy, busy office.
Yes, I do.
We'll say bye. We'll just take a quick look, because West Virginia, our paper here is very important in West Virginia, and we'll show you inside a little bit before we go. Come check it. You're going to make me cry. You're giving me goosebumps. Thank you, Sandy.
You're welcome. Bye, guys.
Bye. Bye, Mrs. Buzzard.
Have a good
day. That was awesome, Super Scholars. Now pause the video and discuss about it. It's Let's Talk time.
Super Scholars, welcome to Positive Actions! This year, for Positive Actions, the Morton County Partnership has a song. We've dusted off our ukuleles, and we're bringing back the Morton County Kids Creed! And guess what? If you're a third, fourth, and fifth grader, you can come to MC After 3.
Oh, yeah.
Learn to play the ukulele and learn this great song that has beautiful positive words, and it talks about you and our great community. Look where we are. We're in Morton County. That's what it looks like on the top of Cape and Mountain. All right, let's try to do this song so you can learn it too. Here we go.
One, two, three, four. I can be kind and caring too for others.
There's only one like me, filled with valuable qualities. I'm made wonderfully. I can be kind and caring too, for others and for me. It's the right thing to do. I know that my home, school, and community have people who care about me. When I get up for school, I think of that golden rule. Treating others just and fair will show students I care.
Be nice, be kind, be strong.
We all want to get along.
Oops, to make today the best.
And all I show respect. I can be kind and caring too, for others and for me. It's the right thing to do. I know that my home, school, and community have people who care about me. Positive actions I will choose, helping others and my school. Get us all to reach our goals with safe, responsible rules.
Oh, I can't get the note. I can't get it. We are all students that care at school, at home, and play. Students can change the world beginning with today.
Yeah! I can be kind and caring too, for others and for me. It's the right thing to do. I know that my home, school, and community have people who care about me. We have people who care about me.
Okay, we made it through the song! Yay! We care about you guys! Alright, scholars, check out this beautiful scene.
Alright. Hi, Possum Partners. Welcome to Mindfulness Minutes. It's Fun Friday on the Daily Community Vlogcast. Listen as Lacey Kidwell, school therapist, will lead us all in a guided meditation.
Most comfortable and wherever you can take some time to do this script and just relax and get a break from your day-to-day routine. We're going to first begin by inhaling and exhaling, relaxing all the muscles in your body and releasing all of the tension that you may be feeling. Focus first on releasing the tension in your head, neck, and shoulders. Inhaling and exhaling, taking your time to fully relax those muscles. Next, focus on your back and your abdomen, relaxing your muscles as you inhale and exhale slowly. Continue to breathe at whatever rate feels most comfortable for you. Inhaling through your nose and exhaling through either your mouth or your nose, whichever feels most relaxing to you. Lastly, focus on your legs and arms, releasing all tension in your muscles as you continue to inhale and exhale, slowing your breath to a comfortable rate. Now that you have released any tension from your body, imagine you are lying down on a soft, fluffy white cloud, feeling the soft and billowed cloud underneath your relaxed body as you calmly breathe and gaze up towards the sun and clouds above you. Inhaling and exhaling as you continue to relax deeper into the fluffy cloud. Take a few moments to just breathe and reflect on one or two small but lovely things that may have occurred throughout your day so far, or perhaps something that you were looking forward to. What made those things or experiences you may be anticipating so lovely? Continue to indulge in those thoughts as you lie down peacefully on the soft, fluffy cloud. Inhaling and exhaling, continuing to relax your breathing in your body. Taken a few moments from our day to relax, we will begin to return to our day from our peaceful place as we wiggle our toes and fingers and slowly open our eyes. Keeping in mind that we can revisit this place in our minds anytime and anywhere. Thank you all for listening. I hope you are staying healthy and safe, and I look forward to doing this again soon for you. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us from your home, your school, or your community.
Gracias por acompañarnos desde vuestra escuela, hogar o comunidad.
And remember, you are unique, you are important, and you are wonderfully made.
Recordad, sois especiales, importantes y maravillosos.
Aww. Bye. All right.
Again soon for you. Thank you.